बिस्मिल्लाह अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह वस्सलातु वस्सलाम अला रसूलुल्लाह सल्लम। माय रिस्पेक्टेड ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, एज आई हैव स्टार्टेड यू नो शेयरिंग विद यू फ्यू क्वालिटीज वी लर्न एज ए दाई फ्रॉम द लाइफ ऑफ द प्रॉफिट सल्लम। इन माय फर्स्ट एपिसोड आई हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट क्लैरिटी, सर्टेनिटी, कमिटमेंट एंड कन्विक्शन इन दाई, दीज थ्री सीज एज ए क्वालिटी। In second episode, I have given you description, what is the importance of credibility of a da'i. And today, inshallah, I'm going to talk about emotional intelligence. This is a new terminology that we have discussed in last 100, 200, 300 years. But Prophet Muhammad SAW has taught us what is the meaning of emotional intelligence. That you know your emotions and you know how to handle them, how to channelize them, how to control them, how to use them in the best possible way, and at the same time you understand the emotions of other people in front of you, so you can give your response in a way that you can bring the hearts together. You make the other person in front of you feel connected to you, my brothers and my sister. That's why it is said about Prophet ﷺ that he was emotionally in tune with the people around him. He was connected with the people, not just emotionally, but intellectually, practically, physically. My brothers, that he was connected with the people. And he knew, he was able to understand the psychology of the people around him. So he was able to appreciate their feelings. So he was able to make the people around him comfortable. There was never been a time anybody was uncomfortable sitting around Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, my brothers and my sisters. So you know, he has taught us what is the meaning of developing relationship. That is part of emotional intelligence. You know, traditional cultures, they teach us how to develop relationship. The modern culture teaches us how to do networking. For relationship, you need closeness from the hearts of the people. And for networking, you need distance. The traditional culture we learn from the life of Prophet Muhammad SAW is to bring hearts together, to make hearts connected, to develop relationship that everybody can feel that you love him the most. You know, I'm going to share with you few of the stories to understand what really exactly this emotional intelligence is. When Sahab is with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that how he was consoling them, how he was comforting them, how he was responding when they are distressed, when they are going through any hardship and difficulty, or whenever they are going certain situations in their life. And we always find that he always have given comfort to everybody around him. If there was a situation, you know, in his own home where there was a difficult situation, but he was always able to handle it with a smiling face. And you know, the only person who can smile and can give you comfort no matter what the situation is, the person who is feeling secure for himself in all dimensions of life. If he is at home as a man, as a qawwam of the house, he feels secure. So if his wife creates any situation at his home, he does not feel insecure as a man. Rather, he smiles and he tries to diffuse the situation. If anything happens in the life of the Prophet Muhammad in his house, he was always ready to smile and diffuse the situation instead of aggravating it, because he was feeling secure. that nobody can challenge who he is, his status. If anybody will endorse, it's not going to increase or decrease his status as a man at home, as a husband at home, as a father at home, as a Nabi and Rasul when he is outside home or inside home. You know, one of the stories we hear about, one time he was with Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha at home alone. There was nobody in the room. But look at about from the perspective of emotional intelligence, that how he approaches his own wife in the privacy of their own room. He could have said what he said out loudly, that Aisha, I know, he goes and whispers in her ear, that Aisha, I know when you are angry with me and when you are happy with me. See, to bring the emotion level at the same connected heart, he goes and whispers in her ear, that I know. And here he is saying to his Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha few things, that Aisha, whenever you say anything, I pay full attention to it. Not only that, I listen what you say, but I pay attention to every word you utter, every word you say. So I know when you are angry with me, you say Qasam of Rabb of Ibrahim. And when you are happy, you swear, you say take oath and Qasam of Rabb of Muhammad. And look at the response of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. See how he created the situation. Instead of saying out loud, instead of saying with angry mood, with angry words, he created the situation that he made the person feel connected and telling the person, I understand your emotions and I appreciate your emotions and I acknowledge your emotions and this is my response. And now the response of the person, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, says, Ya Rasulullah, no matter what word I use, I am happy or angry, but wallahi, the love I have for you in my heart never changes, never decreases. My respected brothers and my sisters, the lesson we learn from this aspect of the life of the Prophet ﷺ, that he was very sensitive about the emotions and feelings of the people around him. You know, one time, one of the priests of Nasara, Christians, came to Masjid Nabvi and he was sitting with Prophet Muhammad ﷺ and he confronted the Prophet and he said on his face that whatever you are saying is nothing but a lie and you are fabricating everything. Imagine in Masjid Nabvi, this, you know, priest of Nasara saying this to Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And as I said, you know, when you feel secure that you do not need endorsement of anybody, you are already satisfied, settled in the domain of your life in all dimensions, then really it frees you from the endorsement of everybody but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And imagine this Nasara, priest of Nasara, is saying that on his face in Masjid Nabvi. But remember one thing, brothers and sisters, when you feel secure in all dimensions of your life, all the domains of your life, you do not need anybody's endorsement. As I said before, nobody's endorsement will change your status. The Prophet, in reply, instead of getting angry and upset with this priest, he smiled and said, okay, if that is the case, then you wait and I will wait. And the day will come when we both will know that who was on truth and who was lying. my respected brothers and my sisters, in conclusion, what I will say, that we should be very sensitive about the feelings, emotions of other brothers and sisters who are around us. You know, in the example I mentioned about Hazrat Aisha radhiyallahu ta'ala anha, what she said, but one more point I want to add in that example, that in some of the cultures, we do not allow sisters, wife or daughter or our children to express their emotions. One of the lessons we learn from that story is that everybody in home has the right to express their emotions. Even wife has right to express, you know, her emotions. She should have this opportunity to express her emotions at certain point. My brothers and sisters, we also have to learn that we should be very watchful and careful when we interact with brothers and sisters. The words we use, the body language we use, the emotions we attach with our words. You know, sometimes we say the same thing, but the way we say it, the words we use, it makes a big difference. So we have to make sure that we create environment that where we are talking in a very friendly environment. Maulana Amin Hassan Islahi Sahab has said, you know, in Tazkiyah Nafs book, that if you are arguing with somebody, if you want to present your perspective about something in response of somebody's, you know, question, and if your voice is going up and you are getting angry, that means that you should stop there and you should do your tazkiyah. You need your tazkiyah. Whenever you are responding to brothers and sisters, you should not get angry. Your voice should not go high. Your heartbeat should not start beating very fast. That means you do not have any control on your emotions. How many times it happens that we injure the hearts of our brothers with our words, with our body language, with the way we express our emotions to them. My brothers, when we are part of Islamic movement, when we live in a community as a ummah, when we live in larger community, among us there are Muslims, non-Muslims, at all levels we have to be very careful when it comes to showing your emotions, sharing your emotions, giving people feedback, interacting with people, responding to people. We should be very watchful and careful and sensitive about the feelings of other brothers and sisters. I will close with this dua, that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me this tawfiq, that I follow what I just said. And I will pray for everyone that we should be very careful, because we do not want to be among those people about whom Prophet ﷺ has said that, do you know the real poor person? People say the one who has no money. Prophet said, no, the real gharib, the real poor person is the one, he goes in Yawm-e Akhirah, and when his accountability is happening, he comes with lots of good deeds, lots of good deeds, mountains of good deeds. But then he has slandered somebody, he has abused somebody, he has cursed somebody, he has used foul language against somebody, and all these people come and file claim against him, and all of his good deeds are given to these people. And when all his good deeds are finished, but still there are people in the line, they are claiming that he has transgressed us, he has abused us, there are still people there. So now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to order, take out the sin of these claimers and put in this person's account. the one who came with mountains of good deeds, and he's left in his baggage the bad deeds of other people. My brothers and my sisters, that's why we should be very careful when we are dealing with people at home, in community, at workplace. Every word we say, every emotion we express, we will be accountable one day in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is huququl ibad. This is not huquq Allah. This is huququl ibad. And huququl ibad, Allah will not let it go without addressing this issue with the people who were affected by my bad action, my emotions, my cursing, my, you know, the way I reacted with the people. So we do not want to be among the poor people, the real poor people on that day. We want among the people who will be successful on that day. So we should watch and we should clear, you know, our heart with from everyone in this dunya. And we should all request everybody, if they have anything against you, they should make sure they get it clean, cleared here in this dunya. I will pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives you me tawfiq, that we really stay very watchful and careful of all our actions. Wa akhiru da'wana anilhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.